Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We start our lecture with the name of Allah, Most Gracious, the Most Merciful. Please watch previous video on necrosis before watching this video. Images are always accompanied with scenario. The clinical scenario here is a 71-year-old woman, known hypertensive, presented with loss of consciousness that persisted for over an hour. When she became conscious, was unable to speak or move her right arm. A cerebral angiogram revealed an occlusion to her left middle cerebral artery. Now, the hypertension is a known cause of atherosclerosis, and there are thrombi they lodged in the brain cause blockage of the arterial supply. So there are 12 hours take to develop the ischemic changes in the brain. So here you can see a cavity on the hemisphere of the brain, and other specimen showing a cavity and surrounding edema, and other specimen showing cavity because ischemia causes liquefactive necrosis, and which is leave behind cavity. So necrosis, old lesion show cavitation. Now microscopically, this is the normal brain histology showing glial cells, neurons and neurofil. The first morphological changes are the cytoplasmic microvacuoles, and then the red neurons marked eosinophilia and nuclear pycnosis. So there is loss of architecture, there is disintegration of cell, and then after a few hours there is polymorph nuclear leukocytes, then mononuclear cells. Mononuclear cells consist of macrophages, lymphocytes and plasma cells. They are replaced by foamy macrophages because they clear the debris. Here you can see foamy macrophages, and in the center there is liquefactive necrosis. Sometimes older foci, they are surrounded by proliferation of blood vessels. Now gross and microscopic view in the same picture. Now we can summarize the findings. Ischemia causes death of neuronal tissue. Changes appear after 12 hours. Neuronal cytoplasm develop microvacuoles. There are pink red neurons. Nucleus undergo pycnosis. There are neutrophils, and then neutrophils are replaced by foamy macrophages. Now the microglia, the resident phagocytic cells of the brain, become activated. Tissue begins to undergo liquefactive necrosis because of the enzyme released by neutrophils, macrophages and neurons. After 2 to 3 weeks, macrophages take clean up debris, and then after several months, cavity surrounded by glial fibers. There is no collagen fibers. Now clinical scenario, grass morphology and microscopy we take into account, and the type of the lesion or provisional diagnosis is liquefactive necrosis, and in the brain ischemia is the cause of liquefactive necrosis. Now another clinical scenario, because liquefactive necrosis is the loss of normal architecture, and this may occur in fungal or bacterial infection. A 30-year-old homeless man, known case of infective endocarditis, developed severe headaches and weakness of right side of the body. CT scan showed a cavity. So here is a cerebral abscess which is creamy white appearance. There is a cavity lined with yellowish surface. Here is another specimen. So infective endocarditis is the source of infective emboli. Outer surface is creamy white, discrete lesion with central liquefactive necrosis. Now this is the microscopy of the brain showing loss of normal architecture, the destruction of the normal architecture, and because of the neutrophilic infiltrate, the necrotic area on the left side, and cerebral cortex in the right side, and there is a thick fibrous band lined between them. So this is the due to the infection, and there are older sections show parallel fibrosis. So in liquefactive necrosis may be due to bacterial infection, and you can find necrosis of the cells, cellular debris, nuclear dust, inflammatory cells, frequently mononuclear cells, and jitter cells. These are actually foamy histiocytes in the brain. So microscopic findings can be summarized: loss of normal architecture, necrotic purulent center, capsule of granulation tissue, fibrosis and jitter cell, and surrounding reactive brain with edema and gliosis. So there are different stages. These are infected thromboembolus forming a necrotic foci, acute cerebritis, liquefaction and purulent exudates, heavy infiltration by neutrophils on second day, and granulation tissue at the margins 5 to 7 days, and then there is encapsulation by fibrous tissue. So we take into account the clinical scenario, gross morphology and microscopy. So the type of the lesion is, the provisional diagnosis is liquefactive necrosis, cause is bacterial infection, because homeless persons usually are drug addicts in the, and there is known case of infective endocarditis. So death is not opposite of life but a part of it. So watch next video on liquefactive necrosis of skin and the liver. This video has been presented to you by Pakistan Homeschool. Go to YouTube channel and watch other videos as well.